Watch Susan Lee's special two-part interview.
People see Tim Cook on one side, Donald Trump on the other. They see a lot of difference, but you have been able to engage and work together. So how does the relationship work?
There are differences. There's no doubt about that. But you look for intersections. We have reopened factories. So the factories were able to work through the conditions to reopen. They're reopening.
Did you reject a one-on-one meeting with the Canadian Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau?
Yeah, I did.
Why?
Because his tariffs are too high and he doesn't seem to want to move. And I've told him, forget it.
Mr. President, NAFTA. What does that mean for NAFTA? Will you be pulling out of NAFTA?
I don't like NAFTA.
Are you going to notify Congress of
what we're probably going to do is call it the USMC. Good job, too. You do a very good job. Really good. Fortunately, the markets have dropped, would you say, 30% in the last 4 months, right? I think I watched you recently when you said that. I said, I think she's wrong. I think it's actually 32, but that's okay. But a lot.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You broke news there.
Because you both are such big personalities, there's a close economic, political partnership between Canada and the U.S. People are always curious as to how closely you get along. So I'll give you a scale. How about this? If the scale is, bear with me, if the Mexican President Nieto is, say, 1, Macron is a 10, where are you in that sliding scale?
I don't know. I think we're all interested in unpacking that scale she's just generated and why those choices are there. I think it's an interesting read on it.
Okay. So the scale would be at 7?
Tonight, just a few hours ago, we were following riot police who were chasing down protesters down these very busy streets of the Mongkok district.
Hong Kong police, in dealing with these protesters, have upped the armor and have brought in the riot squads.
As the pro-democracy march continues, as you see, the crowds turned out, so did the rains, but this was the first weekend in 2 months that there was no tear gas.
But it also has Hong Kong residents nervous about traveling across the border.
Showing a paramilitary buildup of troops and tanks, artillery, just across a waterway here, just a few kilometers from Hong Kong borders.
Right. I think the takeaway is that Hong Kong stands for freedom and they want democracy.
See, the devastation can be felt, it can be seen. Just a week ago, this...
So as you can imagine, it's pretty loud out here.
But today, shocking the market, the tech and the media worlds by announcing its new streaming service, Apple TV Plus.
iPhone 11 Pro Max, 6.5-inch screen. And take a look at this triple-backed camera here. So it has a wide telephoto and the ultra
person. And it could possibly even land on cars with a QR code in the future.
Now, people want to know, are you still sticking with your timeline of an IPO in the back half of 2019? Because your new CFO, who will start in a few
days. He's starting next week.
Yeah, he says he's not on board yet, though, for a 2019 listing. President Trump thinks that there's a liberal bias in Silicon Valley with big tech companies. Employees of big tech companies have said that they feel that their conservative voices have been silenced. Do you think that's true?
Meg, from what I understand, Jennifer Lopez is thanks a million as your most popular on the platform in the first week, but you're giving it away for free for 90 days. I'm just wondering how many of these customers will stick with you when they have to start paying.
It should be a meritocracy, meaning it should be based on your academic scores, your extracurricular activities, and nothing ambiguous like my personality, which is so subjective. I mean, courage, bravery, saying that Asian American students lack that, it's insulting.
It is insulting.
Day-to-day stresses and concerns still have not been alleviated. We have 20 million Americans filing for unemployment benefits over the past few weeks. And small businesses like this here in New York City still remain shut.
I talked to Fox Business News correspondent Susan Lee.
There are a lot of companies that understand what you're going through because they're going through the same things. So talk to your credit card companies, talk to your mortgage underwriters, those big banks, and also talk to those that underwrite your student loans.
Stocks plunging, trading halted again for a second time this week, and only for the second time since 1996.
After the worst day on Wall Street since 2008, we saw the third biggest points gain in history.
Wow, very financially savvy your viewers are. So, Shannon, I would say that my favorite indicator is probably the 10-year yield, which is what your mortgage rate is based on, by the way.
Monday. And yes, we do more of our shopping online these days, but bricks and mortars are still opening.
In China, there's a cultural thing called face and respect. And arguably right now, this U.S. president is best when it comes to optics. In China, optics is part of the culture. Show me.
Right now,
the also breaking this evening, the top aide to Juan Guaido.
We're less than an hour to go to the closing bell. I'm Susan Lee.
Yes, it does. So a four-day winning streak in jeopardy.
Is out the hallway on the phone. There she
is. Markets capping off a wild week with all three major indices closing down after hitting brand new record highs.
Does this really make sense at the end of the day when, you know, you had this transformative opportunity in Long Island City in New York where you could have seen 25,000 jobs, high-paying jobs, of at least on average of $150,000. And this company was willing to invest $2.5 billion in the first year just to get the infrastructure in. And that investment could have extended and multiplied to tens of billions in the future. Was this a lost opportunity for New York City?
It wasn't long ago that President Trump was taunting Little Rocket Man with fire and fury. Now there may be some kind of deal. How has Trump succeeded where previous presidents have failed?
He says, look, we are part of American heritage. We are steeped in American heritage. We have founded here.
Listen, I mean, upgrading the grid is going to cost so much money. Think of all the transmission lines, the power grids across the country.
Lots of questions today as to how the 737 MAX was certified to fly and how it was deemed to be safe in the sky.
Can I just say that growing up in a household watching a single mom raise four kids on her own, I respect and I admire the hustle.